Hi, thanks for joining us for the Nashville Fitness and Beauty Roundup. We have a very special segment for you today. We found out about this very interesting fitness studio called the Chromebar in downtown Nashville. And as we learned about what they offered, we realized we just couldn't do it justice talking about it in the studio. We needed to go down there and talk to the owner, Althea Austin, and have her show us what it is they do. So let's go. Thanks for joining us again at the Nashville Fitness and Beauty Roundup. We're at the Chromebar, and Althea is going to show us a few moves, starting with a few beginner moves for someone like me, who might just walk in and have no experience whatsoever, just try a few basic things.
Yep. This is a combo that you would find in our basic pull class or our beginner series class, which is called Brass Girls. So I'm going to do a pirouette into a spin, which is a momentum-based spin, down to the ground, and then I will come up and do a pull sit. And
okay.
I'm going to teach you the spin part of it.
Oh, boy. Wow. Yeah, I get one small part of that.
Yeah.
Okay.
So for the spin,
okay,
you're going to start with your right arm high and your right foot down. Pull down in your right shoulder.
Okay.
So I'm not actually bending my arm. I'm just sort of pulling my shoulder down and back.
Okay.
To engage it. Then I'm stepping with my left hand and foot across, turning into the pole and looking over my right shoulder. Now here's where I'm gonna create my line for setup. So my right foot comes up and I'm gonna pull down with my hand and pull my shoulder back and reach with my foot in a big circle behind me all the way down to the ground.
Gotcha. Got it. No. Okay. Obviously not to be nearly as graceful.
Right hand high, step on your right.
Okay.
Step on your left.
Step to the left, putting the hand in.
Step with your left foot, put your left hand on. Look over your right shoulder, lift your right foot up. Create a nice line to carry you down.
Wow, not enough momentum.
Not enough, but your form was actually pretty good.
Was it?
Yeah.
I have a good form. Wow, that's cool. I probably just gripping it a little too fearful.
Yeah, you had the death grip.
Careful. That was not as difficult as
manageable.
Yeah.
Do you want to try the sit?
Okay. Sure.
Arms across, elbows together, pull down with your hands.
Okay.
Watch your boy parts.
Turn
to the side and cross your legs.
Turn to the side will be key. I'll give it a shot. I'm not sure. This might be a little interesting. Watch. Okay.
Pull down with your arms. Cross your leg over each other.
Like that?
Yeah, higher on your knees.
Oh.
There.
Just hanging out. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Woo! And so you have to hold that for a while.
Well, if you get better contact with your legs, you won't be holding as much.
Oh, that makes sense. Yeah, I'm like kind of slick with these, but still.
That's why we need skin to stick here.
Skin, okay. So I'd have to wear shorter shorts.
Hot yoga shorts.
Mmm, excellent. Well, was that an intermediate move or was that a beginner move?
No, that's beginner.
Okay. Should we move to intermediate?
Yes.
All right, so let's see one of the intermediate moves. I'm ready. I'm geared up. I noticed, though, you're wearing some serious platform heels there.
I am. I like wearing shoes when I pole dance.
Uh-huh.
I consider them an apparatus, much like a pointe shoe is to ballet. And I use them to not only help me stick, but to gain length in my lines.
Mm.
And also when I'm down on the floor, I get better rotation and stuff.
You probably don't have those in a 13 though, right?
I have a 10.
That probably would hurt.
So
I'll just go barefoot, I'm good.
Perfect.
I don't need the stilettos.
You are always welcome to do either in this space. You can dance barefoot or dance in shoes. That is your own personal style.
Gotcha.
Intermediate class, you're going to start really getting off the ground, and inverting is, I guess, the big word for intermediate.
Wow.
So first I'm going to start with another spin, a little bit more of an advanced spin, and then I will move into an invert and teach you part of it.
Okay. All right. Holy cow. Wow. That's amazing. Oh. Wow. That startled me for a second when your head is plummeting to the floor.
That was just a quick way to dismount.
Yeah.
Go change the music if the song's not right.
Okay. Wow. Yeah, don't show me that part. I can't do that part. There's no way. But this, what you got?
Yep. Well, you're really strong. So we're going to work on your inverts.
Okay.
So I talk a lot about active flexibility in my classes. And as we gain active flexibility here, especially in our stretch classes and fly gym, going to make it easier to go upside down. So I'm having my body weight, like cutting it in half, if I can lift my leg up.
Sure.
To help. So you don't have a lot of active flexibility.
None.
So you're really going to be pulling and feeling like you're lifting your whole weight. The important thing is to keep tucking your pelvis though.
Okay.
And think of getting those knees up
curling
and behind.
Yep. Yeah. Okay.
So your outside arm is going to go high.
Okay.
Outside arm is going to go high. Your rib is to the pole and connected with the pole because we don't want to jump.
Okay.
Okay. You're going to pull your elbows together, take your foot back, and now it's not exactly a deadlift, but your outside leg is going to lead up through a straddle. And you're going to try and go up to what we call chopper.
Oh, boy.
And then lower down by pulling your chest.
So,
outside arm high.
Outside arm high.
Rib to the pole.
Rib to the pole.
Yeah, hips in front.
Of the pole.
Hips in front, yeah. And you're not going to jump. You're going to pull down and squeeze those elbows together. Take your outside leg, start it behind you, and let it drift up to a straddle. Tuck that pelvis.
Yeah. Okay. Because
and
I can't
lift your chest to come back down.
Down.
Chest up, legs down.
Okay. Legs down.
Chest back up.
I think that was as far as I could get with my limited hamstring flexibility.
That was awesome.
Legs back down. But, wow. It's kind of cool to look at the ceiling, though.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of cool to be able to do that. That's wild. Obviously. That's wild. Wow. Cool. Huh. Why do you look at me like that?
Nothing. Just okay. You've got this upside down smile going on.
Okay.
But, inverting is definitely lots of fun, and once you start doing it, you'll think like, how did I go through every day without going upside down?
Yeah, like Batman.
Yeah.
Yeah, cool. Well, I can't even imagine what advanced is, because that felt pretty advanced for me, but let's see some advanced moves.
Okay.
Thank you. melting and knowing my limitations are probably, that might be, a bit, but that is amazing. That would just, that kind of control I can't even imagine. But thank you.
It feels good to move like that.
Oh yeah, I bet it does. That was amazing, very impressive. Definitely an art form, but also physically challenging. And like you said, I can see why so many people are coming here to feel stronger, but also maybe more freedom.
Yeah.
What they're doing. Great. Well, we're gonna stop this part of the segment and go into the fly gym for the next segment. So please check back because you're not gonna miss that either. Thanks again, Althea.